from the Spanish River in Algoma District and Waterfalls Lodge in the town of Spanish, we present the debut episode of Ontario's Xtreme Walleye Angler, a new series focused on promoting the incredible fishing opportunities, the lakes, the lures, and the lodges of Northern Ontario. On this episode, we will feature the Spanish River, located almost entirely within the Sudbury District, except for passages into the city of Greater Sudbury near the communities of High Falls and Turbine and the mouth in Algoma District. We started our day at the mouth of the Spanish River at the Spanish Municipal Marina and met up with our guide on this trip, Big Al Warman.
This is the start of the, this is the mouth here of the river. And out there is Whaleback Channel. Now, it's not too bad this morning. I think we'll go to Whaleback Channel first.
Okay.
Can always come back here.
Okay. Whatever you think, man.
In the river, yeah.
After we loaded up all our rods, gear, and equipment, it was full steam ahead to the Whaleback Channel in search of any dropback walleye that had finished spawning and were now setting up on the channel points and underwater edges and drop-offs.
So there's an edge here too as well, Al?
Yeah, there's a little crevice there, right?
Okay.
Just over here, right over here. Other than that, it's pretty flat out here and, like I say, clay bottom.
Gotcha. Now, this is a spring spot for you, or you fish here all year?
This spot, I take my boat out of the river on the end of June.
Okay.
I fish the upper lakes and I guide the upper lakes.
Okay.
But when the fish leave the river, they come out here, and that's when I come out here.
Gotcha.
But they're coming out of the river now. Like I say, you've seen there's a pile of, fish here.
Gotcha. So a whole worm, huh?
Use the whole worm and just leave a long tail.
Up here?
There's a collar on a worm.
Gotcha. Oh, yes,
it's
yes.
The strongest part of the worm.
Yeah.
So what I do is I put it through the collar.
Yep.
And then feed the long end up the hook a little bit.
Okay. So this is the collar. You're putting it through the collar?
Yeah. And then and take the long end and just feed it up the hook a little bit.
Okay. And you're set. That's it.
You're all set.
Walleye fever. Here we go. Looks tasty.
Well, if you don't catch any fish. There.
There's one right there, something small. What do we have? Walleye. And it is a first walleye for me.
Good deal.
At Waterfalls Lodge. Here we are, fishing out of the Whale's Back Harbor.
That's not a bad one.
With my buddy, Big Al. So you think that's 14?
Yeah, I think it is. Just a minute.
We weigh them and stuff? And
no, I don't weigh them. I just
scale them?
Just give them a little bit of 13 and a half.
So he's got to go back, right?
If you want. It's up to you.
What's so there's no actually slot limit?
Out here, you can have one under 16 one and one over 22 or two under 16 one.
So a few fillets on that one?
Oh, yeah, there's two fillets on that one. If
there's
you want.
Fillets right there. Fishing here with Al.
It wouldn't give you
a Waterfalls Lodge. Can you call them? Like actually put them in and then release as you can?
Yeah,
okay,
you
let's
can.
Do that. How's that sound?
All right.
We're fishing out of Waterfalls Lodge in springtime, walleyes in the Spanish River. They come out to the Whaleback Harbor here. Al's got it pegged. 30 plus years of guiding and stuff. And he's got a little area where it drops off to like a little reef. And I'm just using just a plain jig head, man. Pink with chartreuse. Obviously my sensitive St. Croix. I got the 6'8" medium action. And we're just gonna have some fun. You know, you want to catch some walleyes and stuff, Ontario's got everything, man. From river fishing, lake fishing, you name it. But the thing is, come on out. These lodges are here for you because they can help put you on nice, tasty walleyes in Ontario in spring. Let's get back at it, put another worm on the hook, and catch some more walleyes. Is it time to have some fun, Al?
Right on.
Let's do it. One thing about these walleyes and stuff, and yeah, it's fantastic to go to areas that have big trophy walleyes because, hey, who's kidding who? Well, I love to catch big fish, but I mean, for eating size walleyes, you can't beat these. Those fish that are 13 to 15 inch, perfect. In the lake, at 16.1 and above, you gotta let them go. 13 to 16 inch, 17 inch, get them in the river, they're perfect for dinner. Let that jig go down. Slow lifts, and drop. And it's only clay and sand here, so maybe it's stirring up some of the bottom of stuff. They know it's there. Walleye, they see everything. Right there, there's a fish right there. Right here. I got a walleye, I'm pretty sure. Let's see. Oh, might be an eater, Al. What do you think? Probably an eater, huh?
Oh, he's an eater.
Yes. Look at that. A walleye eater. I'm gonna have to put him on a little sub bun, eh? A little submarine sandwich?
Yeah, I'll give him a measurement here.
Okay.
He's 15 and a half.
So he's an eater.
Yep.
Perfect.
Nice fish.
We'll put him with the others, huh?
Yep.
Beautiful. Go join your buddies. At least we're catching some lunch, huh?
Right on.
Right on. Thanks, Al. It's all about knowledge, local knowledge. And Big Al, he knows, he's been on these waters for like 30 plus years. So when you come to these Ontario lodges, regardless of where you go, you know, they have guides that work with them, guides that sometimes part-time come to the lodge and lift and stuff, and really invest in a few extra bucks, but have a guide who can put you right on those fish, whether you have your boat or use his boat. It just makes your whole vacation a lot easier and more efficient to get right on the fish right away. The walleyes, usually when they commit, hey Al?
Yeah. And the bigger the walleye, the easier it is to bring in until he sees the boat.
Or the net, right?
Or the net, either one. Had the guy yesterday there, he had one on. He says, I got a log. I says, bring him in slow. He kept winding and he kept winding. He had a lot of line out. It's got to be a log. No. All of a sudden.
There's a decent fish, I think, Al.
Yeah. All of a sudden he saw the boat and that was all hell broke loose.
I think it's a Walter. Yeah. Yep. It's a Walter.
Is it a netter?
No, just one of those eating size, eh?
Yeah, right on.
Yeah. You think he pushes the, he's almost the same size as the first one, huh?
Yeah, he probably would be.
Let's see real quick. Tip.
Just he's 13.
We'll call him out, okay? Little eaters.
No problem.
We'll call him out. That one, I think, is lonely by himself.
Give him a partner.
You know what? When you're walleye fishing like any other kind of fishing, you catch a few small ones, and you're like, oh, it feels okay. But you know when you get a good one, when all of a sudden it stops, right?
Well, they come in like lunkers.
Yeah.
You know, they don't fight, yeah. Like I say, till they see the boat.
Yeah. But the bigger ones, when they shake that head, you know they're bigger fish, eh?
Yeah.
Whoa, and your rod just, you know, thumps slow. It's like, you know it's a walleye. Someone better be getting the net. All right, let's get back out and have some more fun, man. Man, is there an easier way to catch walleyes and fun? Sitting in the boat with your buddy, drifting back, watching your line, waiting for the fish to say, knock, knock, set hook, and catch them. Come on, all walleyes. Come on, boys. You just know when it's a walleye. It just all of a sudden there's just weight. Sensation, I'm gonna call it. Perch and stuff, it's more of a rattle. The walleyes, it's just weight. Now lean back, set, fight, and don't drop the rod. You drop the rod, that's where you can lose that fish. Keep that tension on, you're gonna catch him. Come on, big walleye. 18 to 20 incher would be just ideal.
And it hurts you, you gotta throw them back.
Yeah, okay, so only one under, one over 18 you can keep?
Yeah, one over, out here it's one over 22.
One over 22, but under 22?
Under 22, 16-1.
Okay. There's one right there.
Jeez, what am I doing wrong?
This one feels not bad. This is the bigger one for sure, Al. Oh yeah.
Captain.
Yeah, look at. Yeah, he's pulling a little bit of drag. Uh-oh. He's right up front here. Let's see. Oh yeah, that's a better walleye right here. Look at. Right there. Whoa, might be a good eater. Let's see. Right there. Is that an eater?
That's an eater. I'm pretty sure it is. There you go. That's a nice fish. I think we'll have to throw him back.
So the size out here that you can keep is what?
One over 22.
Yep.
And one under 16-1.
Yep.
Or two under 16-1.
Okay, so 16-1. Okay. So we'll get, as long as he's...
I'm pretty sure this is a throwback.
Okay.
That's why they make rain wash my carpets. Yeah, he goes back.
17-incher.
18.
Actually. 18.
18-incher.
So we need to catch him 16 and under, huh?
16 and under. He's okay. Beautiful eating fish, though, that one there.
Yeah. So if that was a river fish, you can keep it.
River fish, right? You keep him.
But out here, we have to let him go. Okay, walleye, at least I got to taste him, huh? Let's let him go right here. All right, walleye, you're lucky today.
Sometimes it hurts.
Yes. Bye. Hard part of the worm, put it through the nose, and I take it, and I just push it up inside, on a bit, and a little tag end. That's it. Look at that little thing going around. Now, if you were a fish, would you grab that? That little tail like that? It's just so munchy. But to walleyes, they can't resist it. They come up to it, smell it. Hey, it's meat, and they eat it. Light pitch underhand. Let it fall to the bottom, quarter ounce jig, 6 pound line. And obviously that sensitive St. Croix is catching walleyes on Waterfalls Lodge. Fishing out here, Whaleback Channel. And it goes out to Lake Huron. And those fish, like Al said, they spawn in the river. They come up early this year in April when the ice came off. And then they do their business and they head back out slowly. And what we're fishing is one of the spots that Al has that they progressively go back out to Lake Huron. Suspend and I guess feed on bait fish and stuff. So we're just fishing potential spots. I guess they're locations where they just stop and feed, you know, they don't just head right out. And this is one of the spots we're catching some fish. I love the walleyes, man. You got to try it because it is fun. The only thing is letting those 18 inches go, I hate it. But hey, helps the population.
Don't forget to mention that the guide got tied up.
The guide got tied up. Get us a couple 16 inchers. He was just 2 inches long. Oh boy. He needs to get his friend. So this is one of those instances where you need a smaller fish.
Yeah.
How ironic is that in fishing? You want to catch a smaller one, Al. What do you think, Al? We head to the river?
Yeah.
Okay. And now we're going to the Spanish River. Here we go. Gonna do some drifting in the river for walleyes.
Closed captioning of this program presented by Sportsman Protein Shake.
The easiest way to catch walleyes with a simple lead head jig and an earthworm. You talk about simple way to catch fish? That's as simple as it gets. That's what we're going to do right here on the Spanish River.
Okay, we're actually now in the Spanish River fishing for drop back walleyes. They've done their business. We're just going to drift along the bottom and balance our little jigs and worm combination off the bottom and wait for that sensation, which is walleyes. And hopefully we hear that, which means someone get the net. Let's have some fun.
The water's the right temperature too, 61 degrees. Anywhere between 58 and 62 is good temperature for walleye.
So this is a little bit different. Here you're letting the line out. You gotta make sure you're making contact with the bottom. And I'm just holding the rod on an angle where I'm pointing at the line where the jig is. And my finger is on the line too, just for a little bit extra sensation. And lift and drop. And if I feel
all of a sudden some weight and stuff, I won't set right away. I'll give it a bit, let them take it, then lean back, and hopefully that hook finds the meat.
I take my wife fishing. All I hear is, get the net, get the net. Gee.
I think women are good because they're patient, huh?
She sits at the back there.
Yeah.
And fishes down by the motor, right down beside the motor.
Patient, especially for walleyes, right?
Any fish, you gotta have patience.
Sure.
That's, I got lots of patience with fish.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. There's a fish right there. Yep, that's
that one.
Yep. Yep, feels good too. Feels really good.
Go ahead. Nice wonder.
Feels like it, yeah. He's definitely a netter. Oh yeah, here he comes up. He's coming up here out. See the, you can see the line out here? He's coming up right. There he is. Oh, just a decent fish. He just felt so much bigger, Al. I think I could probably lift him right up. Let's see. Yes. Little Wally.
That's a nice one.
Yes. Oh. Got that right in the corner of his mouth right there. Oh, boy.
Want to measure him?
It has to be, what?
Take a guess.
16?
He'd be, yeah. He'd be 16.
So he's a legal fish?
Oh, yeah. Oh, he's 15.
15. Still legal?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Eater. Eater in the river. Had him right there in the corner.
See the,
right
see the difference now? The
yeah.
On him?
Yeah. Thick it's fish,
a
aren't they?
Girth.
Yeah. Nice fish. Put him in. Bounced him. Got him on the corner of the jaw right there. Spanish River walleyes in the drift. You talk about exciting fishing, man. It's just fun fishing, you know? Feels like you're just, you go back in time, you know, putting on a minnow on the jig and just drifting, waiting for that weight sensation. A lot of fun.
Hi, I'm Rob from Waterfalls Lodge. We are located in Spanish Ontario, Canada, located in Algoma country. We offer a lodge for fishing, hunting, and ATVing. Full service lodge offering meal plans to do your own cooking and housekeeping cottages. All our cottages are on the waterfront, located with beautiful decks, screened in gazebos, boats, motors, docks, everything's there for you. For fishing, we offer many species in our chain of lakes here, such as smallmouth bass, walleye, and northern pike. And we offer remote lake fishing by ATVs, but we also offer trips to the Spanish River and the North Channel Whalesback. It's phenomenal fishing there, especially for walleye. We offer 15 waterfront cottages, and we can accommodate 45 to 55 guests. And these cottages are luxury in the wilderness. Okay, you're gonna find them clean, well-maintained, and perfect for your family, for a group of guys, father sons, father daughters. We're good for all ages. Okay, we also offer a dining room. And there we serve our meal plans. You can choose the full American plan or just a dinner plan, or you can do your own cooking in our housekeeping cottages. Our dining room is fully licensed. We offer entertaining there, such as satellite TV, pool table, license bar. And this is a place where we serve our meals, but we also gather to entertain everybody and for one another to meet each other. If you're looking for an incredible fishing trip for smallmouth bass, walleye, northern pike, we have it here. You just saw Carl fishing for walleye on the Spanish River. Phenomenal fishing, a hot spot for walleye. You gotta check it out. Give us a call, please contact us. We'll set you up with a wonderful trip.
You know, you're balancing the back of the boat, balancing the boat. You feel that light tap, and a couple things happen. Sometimes they're sharp, or all of a sudden it's just a weird, mushy feeling. All I do is pull back on the rod slightly when I know that something doesn't feel right. You know, it's not a snag, it's a fish. Set hook, don't drop the rod. Keep the bend in the rod,
catch up any slack line you may have, and just always keep the bend in the rod until that fish finds the net. Right there.
Good deal.
Yep. That's another heavy fish, Al.
It's hard to tell when they're deep, huh?
Man, they don't want to come up. They're not in a hurry to come up.
Decent sized fish.
Nice one.
Fillet
a
fish, right?
Yeah. Be nice if you could catch them filleted already, though.
Yeah. I felt like I was starting off fishing again in the old days with some live worms, you know, little jig heads and the rods, and just shooting the breezes at him as we drifted down the river, you know, like Huckleberry Finn and Tom Sawyer, going down the river and catching some fish.
Our trip to Waterfalls Lodge was once again a very enjoyable and memorable experience with luxury in the wilderness. The gracious hosts and wonderful staff greeted us with a warm and sincere welcome and strived to make each visitor and vacationer feel at home. Their success depends on your satisfaction, so you'll want to return again and again, just like the fabulous sunsets do at Waterfalls Lodge. Visit Waterfalls Lodge, where you'll come as a guest and leave as a friend. Rob and Kathy look forward to welcoming you to their family-friendly atmosphere. The Xtreme Walleye Angler has been presented by Go Fish in Ontario, It's Catching, St. Croix Rods, Best Rods on Earth, Sportsman Protein Shake, Power Your Obsession. Catch us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.